What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Dive Vibe, and today we are going to be rating scuba gear brands in different tiers. There's nowhere to hide, scuba companies. We're coming for you. All right, so there's a lot of dive brands out there, like a ton. Which ones are good and which ones are bad? Today, me and my friend Neil here are gonna find out. Neil, why don't you tell them a little bit about yourself?
Hi guys, my name's Neil. I've been diving since 1997.
That's a long time.
Yeah, it certainly feels like something. I don't even know what it is necessarily. But I was certified in Lake Tahoe. It was 42 degrees, and I had spent a whole bunch of my youth and afterwards diving in California. Then I came out to Hawaii in 2000 and started diving here. And so much so that my dad and I started working at Jack's since 2006 part-time. We'd come over during the summer, and then we go back home. In 2009, I moved out here full-time. And I instructed, I dive guided, I ended up captaining, and now I am a, quote, marine operator at Arizona State University.
In Hawaii,
yes, it's very odd. We have a dive research facility here. We do a whole bunch of different stuff all along the west coast of Hawaii, but I manage their vessels, I do a whole bunch of their diving, and all that kind of stuff. I do what I can for them.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for being here today.
No problem.
I appreciate it. Cool, so basically what we're gonna do is we are going to go through a bunch of brands that I've written down, just kind of, you know, the bigger ones that I could think of, and we're going to rate them in a tier list. S, and then A through D, and then F for the real failures.
S is the good stuff, right?
Oh, S is, oh, yeah, okay, that's okay. S tier. You know, like when you're car racing, you got the S. That's nope. Like a Lamborghini Aventador or something.
I don't know what that is.
But anyway, so I've got these listed alphabetically so that it doesn't look like we played favorites or anything. It also is convenient because we get to talk about Apeks and Aqualung at almost the same time.
Great.
And before we get started, I'd just like to take a second to thank our patrons who make videos like this possible. If you'd like to support Dive Vibe, check out the link to Patreon in the description. So, Apeks. S, A, B, C, what do you think?
I'd probably give them an A.
An A?
I wouldn't give them S necessarily. There's a whole bunch of Apeks stuff that I like.
Yeah.
But I don't know if I'd give them an S.
I think my criteria for an A is something that, you know, whether the product is like made for the type of diving that I'm doing or not, I know it's gonna be a solid product. It's gonna be made well. And everything from Apeks is made, you know, very robust, tough. So yeah, I think I'd agree. I think an A for Apeks.
I would too. The only reason I wouldn't give them an S is because, man, like, they'll make either some unnecessary stuff that costs too much money. Like, I don't need that. Thanks a whole bunch for charging me, what, like $30 for a weight pocket?
Yeah.
Or something even more so.
It can be really expensive.
And they're made out of pleather.
Oh, and those reel, or the spools? Yeah, the lifeline spools? Oh my god.
Those things are like $200.
They are so nice, they are so expensive.
It doesn't cost that much to machine
aluminum. There's no way.
Bro, there's no freaking way.
It's like a dive guide silver spoon or something like that. Like,
are they tight?
It's a flex.
Hell yeah, it is.
That spool is a flex. So if you need a flex, that's what you need.
Yeah.
Aqualung. Apeks, owned by Aqualung, and they're all owned by like Air Liquide or whatever. But anyway, what would you give Aqualung?
I think I would give Aqualung probably another A for the most part. Things like Aqualung and Scuba Pro, I really like kind of base it off of like customer service. I don't know.
Yeah.
Like, do they have a whole bunch of stuff? Do I use it all? No. I don't need 90% of Aqualung BCs. No, thank you.
Yeah.
You know, they're constantly trying to reinvent the wheel, do this other thing. I don't need that junk.
But, well, in the interest of me defending myself on the amount of ratings I gave this, because I think I probably went a little overboard. The amount of, we probably have too many choices. I'm gonna go B. And the reason that I'm gonna go B is because, yes, it's still a solid product. Everything that Aqualung comes out with is quality and is safe. But I really don't like the styling on the new Legend.
Mm-hmm.
I don't put a 3 in the, I'm not dumb, I'm not stupid. I don't like that.
That's not what they think of you.
They think, oh yeah, this moron, he's gonna love this. I will Legend put 3 in it. It might also be, I don't know. not my favorite thing. And their stuff is like, a little too colorful for me. I mean, I get it, you know, I don't think that dive gear should be just all black. Like, it's fun to have a little color in there, but show some restraint, for God's sakes. And the Galaxy wetsuit, that thing was cool as hell, and they didn't come out with it in men's sizes. What the hell? I want to be fancy too.
The word on the street was is they like purchased some huge roll of material and they just said, cool, we'll take it all, and like nailed out a bunch of wetsuits, and then that was dead. All right, I think I might take a B on Aqualung. I think that's fine.
All right, Atomic.
I like to say something about Atomic that I probably told some people.
I bet you would.
Man, everyone's always saying how tight their stuff is all the time, and like every one of those regs has that stupid like 45 degree angled ball bearing on them.
The swivel?
Yeah, everyone's like, oh, this is the best stuff, Atomic is so, it's like, no, dude, that's just some, you believe what some guy in a shop told you someplace at some point in time, and you've taken it for...
You got taken advantage of, I'm sorry, you got took for a ride.
So, I don't know. I've never had an Atomic anything, but people love that stuff. Tell you what, their BCs suck.
Dude, I really don't like their BCs.
Super hard.
I will say, though, on the more reasonable end of their regs, that design, I kind of dig their whole, it's the first stage, and you get one that has like everything titanium, or maybe it's not all titanium, and they get a little bit less expensive. It's a super quality regulator. The regs are super duper high end. They really,
to their credit, they really are quality. One of those,
it's just like a Mark 25.
I've never
it's
a bunch seen of one of those like little things break.
Yeah,
I've never had that happen.
I've never seen one of them free. As far as if you do need a swivel, like if you really feel like you need one, you could do worse because they are reliable. I've seen those off-brand Omni swivels blow up underwater. I've never seen a name brand one blow up underwater, but I don't want to talk shit about Omni swivel because I like a lot of their products. Omni swivel is not on this list, so cool.
Is it really?
It's not on this list. Oh, so conveniently, man, I don't have to talk about it. I have way too much to say about Omni swivel.
Let's talk about it.
The funny company. Okay, but we gotta name them. I say it, you know, if Atomic was only doing regs, they'd be getting an A out of me. No problem. Maybe S if they changed a couple things.
Hey, they make masks.
The masks are great. Right. Honestly, some of them can be kind of expensive, but the Atomic Frameless, I love that mask. Somebody stole mine.
But we're putting them for Atomic.
I want to give them an A because all their stuff is quality. Like, I know when I pick it up, it's not going to break eventually.
Oh, they got weird ass BCs.
The BCs are weird.
I'm over that shit.
I hate split fins. It's a thing on this channel. I hate them. I've had people leave me nasty comments. Don't leave me nasty comments about split fins. You're gonna fuel me. I love that. Yeah. You know what? Do leave them, because I love it. I'm gonna sip wine and read your comments later tonight. I love that.
Mm.
I hate split fins.
What's the vintage on this comment about split fins? Oh, I tell you, was it aged in an oak barrel? Fuck you. Stupid split fin ass nonsense. Come to Hawaii, we're gonna staple that shit back together, I swear to God.
I gotta give them a B, because I can't go lower than a B for Atomic, because their stuff is just, like, it's a great product. The Cobalt, wasn't a fan of that, the thing broke a bunch, and I don't like host computers. Anyway, we're gonna talk about Atomic too much. I'm giving a B, we're moving on. Cressi.
Let's see, I don't know.
You free dive more than I do, and they're definitely have a big presence in the free diving community. What do you think of that?
I don't know if I would necessarily purchase anything of theirs just on name brand alone. I know a lot of people ever talk about Cressi, and I'm just, I don't know.
I've had multiple Cressi products, and their regs are a little funky to me, but at least they make their own regs, it seems like. A lot of the smaller companies don't make their own regs, they buy them from somewhere else, but.
Cressi makes their own regs?
I think so. Let me know in the comments if somebody knows. I could be wrong. But they look so unique. They don't look like anything else. They've had some cool designs on their BCs. Like, as far as a rental BCD goes, that pocket where you can just stick the weight in it and then you close it up, and it's very simple. You know how it works as soon as you look at it, which is great for a rental BC.
Yep.
And there's no pockets to lose. Mm-hmm. That's a good idea.
That is real nice.
We'd be losing pockets up in the dive shop.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to give Cressi... there's gonna be bees all over the place. I'm gonna give Cressi a B. Everything's gonna be a B. Okay.
We'll think of something about Cressi later on to give it a C. I'll guarantee it.
It could change.
I'll see some shit tomorrow. Be like, I don't know what I was thinking.
The next one, I don't think either of us have any much experience with. I've used their fins, but they're Deep Six. They're touting themselves as expedition grade dive gear. And we're going purely off hearsay, so take this one with a grain of salt because I've used just their fins.
They have fins?
Yeah, they have, they're actually not bad.
I think I've heard mainly about their rigs and people, from what I've heard, whether that's true, I'm not a tech, I have no idea. That's mm-hmm. very few times that I've opened up a first stage and been like, oh yeah, interesting. Oh, absolutely. Don't do that.
See, I'm on the other side. I am a tech and I do find that shit interesting. Yeah. So we'll go, I haven't opened up a D6 rig though, so I don't know. I'm gonna say we don't have enough information to rate them.
Yeah, sure. Okay. Give it a C. That's passing.
Give it a C.
And for non-visibility.
Okay, I'm gonna...
You'll get there one day, guys.
They sell orange fins, though.
All right, well...
So you know what that means. I'm gonna give them a B for our boy Matt.
For a homie.
For the homie Matt.
And for Keller.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
This is four Bs in a row.
San Francisco Giants.
Dive right.
I like their wings sometimes.
Yeah, so quality products. Again, honestly, I'm leaning towards A and especially since they've made such a huge impact on the dive industry as far as like side mount stuff goes, like for yep. real, like the Nomad and all that stuff was one of the first commercially available side mount BCDs and it changed things. It wouldn't be my first choice for a BC to dive right now. I think we're all kind of going towards something that looks a little bit more like Apeks, or not Apeks, X-Deep, or the
yeah.
new Hollis Katana 2. But I think that Dive Right has a lot of products that have tons of merit. And I think that their stuff is quality. I have an old Dive Right regulator. And when I took the second stage apart to service it, I still haven't put it back together.
Really?
It's just sitting up at the shop. I must have done something wrong because I can't get that thing to tune right. So I threw a different second stage on that regulator. Call it good.
Screw it.
Screw it. What do you think?
I think that, especially earlier on, I think that to credit what you're saying, the Dive Right had a whole bunch of high visibility, especially in technical diving. And in other areas where people wouldn't necessarily
yeah.
see them otherwise. Things like, I don't know, silly stuff like wings or just like little add-ons that you would add to a like harness setup. I think that they have a whole bunch of credibility to them.
Yeah.
And still, like it's still there all the time. Like you go to a dive site that you trust that sells technical diving gear, like you'll see Dive Right there. And man, it's not that expensive and it's
yeah.
solid
yeah.
and it'll last as long as you throw it around in a dirty ass truck or off of a boat and stuff like that. Like I'm down with that. I would never turn down Dive Right Pockets, Dive Right BC. I'll never turn yeah. down any of that stuff. And their regs have always been around and those things are bulletproof as far as I can tell.
Yeah. Another thing, like some of them have been very similar to XTX50. Well, that's that first stage has been ripped off a bunch. The right. second stage, I can tell you, nothing like them.
It's because it's dope.
It is a really, really good regulator. And usually they come, unlike the real XTX50, they come with a fifth port off the end of it.
Right.
The XTX50 only comes with a fifth port and the side mount. So, and you can get the upgrade, so. But anyway, Dive Right, I'm gonna give it an A. This is a solid product. When I'm in cave country, a lot of times the only option is Dive Right when you need something off the shelf.
Yeah, it's right there, that's what I'm saying.
I've used like tons of Dive Right stuff.
Yeah.
And, oh, Lamar Hires, cool guy, and I hear his son is a cool guy too. Met Lamar, really nice guy. So, not that it's getting you any points. You don't get any points for niceness, but it's a plus for me.
Sounds like it.
Yeah.
I don't know.
You think so? Divesoft.
Fine,
dude. That analyzer.
The getting into the weeds of I think of all the technical diving equipment. It's rarely where I feel like you're gonna find someone who like doesn't show up to play.
Yeah.
As far as
tech manufacturers.
Yeah.
They do. Yeah, you're not gonna last long if you're making shit.
No.
Yeah.
I mean, either someone's gonna die on your shit.
But that doesn't mean that they shouldn't be praised for doing a good job.
No, fair enough. Everything that I've seen from Divesoft seems progressive. It seemed interesting. The way, I mean, all those side mount rebreathers seem as if they're kind of really taking on a big stride in sump and cave diving stuff.
Yeah. I mean, we have the best side mount rebreather.
That's right.
That's right. The Kiss Sidewind. but yeah, the Divesoft, the Liberty side mount, killer rebreather. And the Liberty back mount, killer rebreather. Solid.
People are using that side mount one all over the place as like a bailout rebreather or something else for
it. It's the only one that's got that kind of function. I mean, you can use anything as a bailout rebreather, but it's got a bailout rebreather, a bob function. I think it's killer. I think Divesoft is S tier.
Yeah.
That's might be controversial.
No, I think everything has been super solid from them.
Divesoft, S tier.
Was that the first S?
That's the first S.
Shit, we didn't give that to Apex? What the fuck am I thinking?
I think Apex deserves what it got.
Good.
They're lucky. Fuckers. They're lucky to get what they want.
That's right.
Make me a cool rebreather, Apex, and then send it to me.
Or how much free. You don't charge so much for a pair of fucking technical shorts. Sons of bitches.
Because they know that you shouldn't be wearing
it. It's like $150.
Glue some pockets on your wetsuit in a shameful manner like everybody else.
Son's disgusting. Give me some good tech shorts. Beat by Apollo. Stop at new Apollo's. Cop a Henny Sour and I'm puffing Jack Sour. Yeah, I feel a